Hello students, so today we are going to discuss the next very simple chart, that one is scatter chart. But in the previous class we have discussed that line chart is used to connect the markers using a straight line. So scatter chart is just like line chart. If we will not connect those markers using any line, then this will be known as our scatter chart. So in our scatter chart, only markers will be there. There will not be any connecting line. And to draw the scatter chart, we are having the function which is known as scatter function. Okay, so let us go through these lines. A scatter plot is a two-dimensional data visualization that uses dots to represent the values obtained for two different variables, one plotting against y-axis and another plotted again along y-axis. The data visualization is done as collection of points not connected by lines. So here the term which we are going to reference is only marker, because these markers are not connected by any line. So there is no need to change the line color or line style. The only thing we have is the marker, and yes, we can change the type of marker. Okay, now see, it is similar to Betty line chart. The only difference is that markers are not connected by our straight line. If this will be connected by the lines, then this will become our line chart, and for that we have to use the function plot. So here we have used the function scatter function, and the parameters are same. First you have to provide the values for x-axis, then you have to provide the values for y-axis, and then I have written the argument C that stands for color, and color I have chosen red for my marker, and the marker type is asterisk type. So you will have results like this. If you want something else from this one, you may choose any one from these marker value. So accordingly you will have different types of marker in your output. So this is the simplest one. Okay, so you may give title to your chart also. So be informative, but your chart should be completely labeled. So you have to give the X label also, Y label also, and then title of the chart should also be there. So this is the scatter chart. Now the next important one is our bar plot and chart. So you must have draw this earlier also, Bete. So a bar chart represents categorical data with rectangular bars. Each bar has a height which corresponds to a value it represents. It is useful when we want to compare a given numeric value on different categories. It is the most common used chart, Bete. Okay, so when we want to draw a bar chart, what things we needed to keep in our mind, Bete? Let me explain the bar chart using example directly. Suppose, Bete, here we are having x-axis values, we are having y-axis values, and we want to draw the bar chart. So for that, name of the function is bar function. Now what are the different attributes that can be used with bar chart? Let us discuss here. So the x-axis we have to pass, y-axis we have to pass. Here I have given width, okay, that will decide the width of our bar. If you will not provide the width, it will take the default value. Okay, and I have given the color of my bar should be orange. Now see here, this is the simplest bar chart. I have not used with any title or x label and y label, but whenever you will draw the chart, just keep remember to add those x labels, y labels and title to your chart also. Okay, so this is the simplest bar chart. Now suppose we are having Bete these types of, means multiple bar can also be drawn. So here I am having value for one bar chart, this one is the values for another bar chart. So I have to call bar function twice, because we are going to draw multiple bar chart in our figure. So whenever we are using multiple chart in a same view, then it is what to say, Bete? Then it will be better to use label function so that you can call your legend function to let the others know that for which purpose which bar is used. Okay, so here I have given my first bar label as first bar and the second one is labeled as second bar. So when we will call the legend function, it will tell you that okay, this orange color is used for the first bar and this blue color is used for second bar. So here we are having multiple bar chart in a figure. Now let us see, we have used all the numerical data. Nahin, but normally when we are going to draw the bar chart, we are having something like this. Nahin? Some categories are shown by number of data. Now just see here, I have used that. Here we are having five types of languages and here some values are there. Suppose how many students are using which language. This is the first survey and this is the second survey. Okay, and I want to draw the bar chart from these data. So what I am getting the output, then okay, in x-axis we are having five languages, in y-axis Betty, when we are having the data plotting, the bar, the two bars are being overlapped. Okay, then how to overcome this? It will not happen. It will be easier when we are having numerical data, Bete. But when we are having some string value, then some tricks have to be used. Let us discuss that one. Why this overlapping is going on and what to do to skip this overlapping, Bete. Now see, for both the bar chart, we have given that width should be 0.5. So for C++ language, here the in x-axis C++ language is there. So one survey we are having the bar chart here, and for the second one survey the bar chart will also be drawn just here also. So this can be skipped if we will change the width of the second bar chart. Okay, if we will move the place of the second bar chart, then the two bar will not be overlapped. So how to do that, Bete? Now see here, what we will do here for the first one, okay, I have given the width is equal to 0.3. So for the second bar chart, if we will start the positioning from x plus 0.3, then our bar will be moved by that much width. So no overlapping will be there. But it is not so easy, Bete. Lots of error you will get when you will try to add x1 plus 0.3. Suppose, Bete, I will write x plus 0.3. Now see here, x are in the form of string. Nahin, it is list. Already these things we have discussed in the previous chapter. Okay, and when we are adding 3 to our list, it will give us error. We have already discussed today what is the difference between list and array. In case of array, vector addition, vector operation is allowed, but in case of list it is not allowed. Let us try to execute this one, we will have error. Can only concatenate list. So since we are having here list, Bete, it is not possible to add 0.3. So what we will do, Bete, here we are having how many values in x-axis? 5. So we will create an array of 5 different values. This arrange function will do what, Bete? It will give you array of 5 numbers. Okay, so let me comment this one also. Okay, so what we will do, we will add this one, we will add 0.3 to x1. So what it will do, it will, yes, now see here, Betty, bars are not being overlapped, but instead of C++, the name of the language is what we are having, we are having the array elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, because This statement will give you the array elements as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. But we want these names to be added in x-axis. And for that, bete, we are having one function, xticks function, which will change our names of the ticks available in x-axis. These are ticks, bete. This what you are getting here are the ticks on the x-axis. This 0, this 1, this 2, this 3, this 4, these are the ticks on the x-axis, and we want it to be replaced by our C++, whatever the name we are using. So what we have to do, we have to use the xticks function, we have to replace this x1 by x. And now when you will run, you will see the change that, okay, here the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 has been replaced by the string name. So the two things we have learned here, bete, that how to skip, how to avoid the overlapping, and if you want to overlap, then and you are using the string value, then these two things are needed to be added in your code. Okay, so these were all about, bete, what these were all about our bar chart. So I hope you have understood the bar chart. If you are having any kind of doubt, then you can ask me, bete. So thank you for watching.